And that's the kind of comedy you can expect. Maybe we should listen to his beats.
That was hilarious.
Oh, Cipha, it's so cool because, you know, I've seen you multiple times and, you know, you're always running from gig to gig, so it's nice. Yeah, I think you're doing another set here, then you're going somewhere else. So.
Man, that's so dope. Thank you. No, thanks
awesome,
for having
man.
Me on the show.
Thanks
this
so much.
A dope show.
And, hey, go see live comedy because that's what's happening. Comedians open cards! Comedians opening cards, no coffee, and freaking this about my fourth time trying to get him. Finally, he's got the time.
Finally.
Cipha Sounds,
what's
New
up?
York's best.
Man, thank you, man.
Fucking music, comedy, you're like the man.
I try.
I know.
I try.
How long have you been doing comedy?
Since 08.
Right.
I had an on and off start.
Right.
I say seriously in 2011.
And music you've been doing
since
probably
95.
Oh, and everyone knows you from that.
Yeah,
if they don't know you from comedy.
Yeah, did
your set at the Stand.
I did a Stand. It was a weird crowd, but it was fun. I like the weird crowds because then I just say wacky shit.
Yeah.
Oh, should I not curse?
You can do whatever you want. There's no
kids
rules.
Watching? Is this on YouTube Kids?
It just goes YouTube. I don't put it for kids.
But I love kids.
Well, but
not like that.
I didn't say it.
Oh, no one meant
that. I mean, if you wait, there's, oh no, someone already, well.
What?
So, I had a, there's one.
So it's comedians.
Comedians opening
cards,
no coffee.
Good, because I hate coffee.
Right. So you just pick, you know, look at rounds, see if there's something that you know, you remember, who knows, that interests you. You open them, you talk about it for as long or short as you want, you sign one for me, and then you keep the other cards if you so desire.
Jack is dope. What's this?
Well, so this is a pack I made. It says Comic Pains because they have all done it. So Mark Norman has done it. Attell has done it.
Fuck them.
Yeah, exactly.
Is that Shane Gillis?
Yes, Maddie, Wiener opened a pack of whatever. Kojak was opened by Godfrey. Not this pack, but you know.
Right, that's Morgan Mindy.
Three's Company.
Oh, Three's Company's good. That's
Malcolm.
X-Files. I thought it was Malcolm X.
There's Bob Marley cards. I mean,
Marley cards.
It's not Malcolm X, but.
Howard the Duck, Batman, Roger Rabbit, what's this?
Star Trek? From the first movie,
original,
I think.
Oh, the movie, okay.
Yep.
What's that?
Dick Tracy. Hunger Games, Desert Storm.
Desert Storm, like the war?
Yep. Civil War cards were opened earlier. There's a terrorist attack cards, yeah. There's like Bible things. There's Doodle Walkers.
Why is there a Desert Storm?
Because people like different things. Some
people do like different things.
So I have to give a variety. Bill and Ted's Adventure, Maverick, the movie, Bill Nye the Science Guy,
yeah,
T2.
Too many I like.
Well,
what's that?
New Kids on the Block.
Oh, they're on tour right now.
Yeah, the Boston comics are opening that sometimes because they have everyone has a story about them, you know?
Right, that makes sense.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to do. Oh, let's do. Should I do
SNL? SNL people don't see for some reason, but.
Oh, yeah, that's hard to see.
Yeah, it's like that. Jeremiah Watkins opened SNL. He's the only one.
Sounds good.
Yeah. And he's in town right now, too.
I'll do Three's Company.
Oh, Three's Company. You remember the show.
Okay.
And I think she might be the only one. I don't know. Joyce DeWitt might be the only one left of the three.
Yeah, Suzanne died.
Yeah, and obviously Ritter so long ago.
John Ritter was the best. Wait, are these real or you made these?
No, these are real. The only ones I made were the comics. Yeah.
And the gum.
Yeah. And it's insane how many people have eaten it. Starting with Mark Norman. No, I don't suggest it.
That's how you shoot this?
Yeah.
You want to get a tripod or something?
Nope.
Okay, you want to use it?
I'll
give you my tripod. All right, let's do this. All right, let's see. Three's Company, the two spin-offs were the Ropers.
Yes.
And Three's a Crowd.
Ooh, Three's a Crowd, I don't remember.
Do you not remember Three's a Crowd? You remember the Ropers more than Three's a Crowd?
Well, I just do.
Okay, and
was
then Three's a Crowd was after.
Well, maybe I got...
Jack opened his own bistro.
Oh, wow.
And then he had to
one season,
Vicky.
Maybe
one season.
Yeah, I kind of remember something with
now,
a bistro.
Now, who's your favorite blonde from Three's Company? There's Chrissy, a.k.a. Christmas Snow. Then there's Chrissy's cousin, Cindy. And then there was Terry the nurse. I like Terry the nurse the best.
You like the second one?
Third one.
Oh, wow. And you know why Susan Summers left?
That's the, hold on.
Yep.
I like the third,
Sorry.
I would masturbate to Terry the most.
Right.
Suzanne Summers left because she wasn't getting equal pay, maybe?
she wanted to get the same salary as Ritter, who got more money, and then they didn't give it to her. And then, do you remember her on the phone at the end of the episode?
Yeah.
Because they
forced her to do
until
it.
Until the contract ended, so she would be on for like a minute.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And Cindy was her cousin. But the thing about it was, Cindy was just trying to be a fake Chrissy. Like, dumb blonde.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like when they replaced the Duke boys on Dukes of Hazzard. All right, so what we got?
I don't know.
Boom. I should have my glasses for this. But I don't have them. They're at home.
Yeah.
All right, boom. Three's Company. Goalie, Jack, and you make a great centerfold. Okay.
Oh, wow.
I don't remember this one. Who was
and this is probably
with?
The sticker. Yeah, that might be St. Pete. Oh, I think there's a whole... I think this is mostly... They're like stickers. A lot of stickers. I don't know if they still stick, but you know. And you get to keep them all
the way. There was a lot of raunchy jokes.
Yes.
On Three's Company, especially for that time.
You know, there's a group of older women who dress up like Mrs. Roper and meet and like just... They wear the same things. They wear a wig.
On purpose?
Yes. There's like a gang.
Where's that?
I think they meet once a year. You can Google the thing and find out about the Mrs. Roper thing, which just... It would be the wackest thing.
There's one now. Got on a house dress like Mrs.
Roper. Exactly. How does that happen? Right when we say it, someone walks.
I would want to meet those women.
I know. It sounds. I mean, they're out to have a good time.
But you know who the hot one was on Three's Company? Rhonda.
Rhonda.
Rhonda was the neighbor. She was only, I think, maybe the first season. She was always. She was a little. What do you call it?
I don't remember Rhonda.
She was a. What's the word? A minky, minxy, ranchy, raunchy.
Raunchy.
No. Minky, rink. What's the word?
Rink. I don't rink, know. Rinky dinks.
No, rink, rink. you rinky minks. You ratchet minks.
Sphinx. No, I don't know. Trying to rhyme. I don't know.
She was a little slut that lived upstairs. Older. She was like a MILF, but she didn't have kids. She was always up on Jack. All right, put me on a pedestal.
Oh.
Okay. Look, man. Can you see that? John Ritter's physical humor was absolutely amazing. That's a sticker also.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
Here we go. John Ritter, zany bachelor Jack. You know what Three's Company is? Three's Company was a show of three roommates in Santa Monica, California. And at the time, the building they lived in didn't allow men and women to live together.
Right.
So they pretended, they told the landlord that he was gay so that he could live with the two girls. And then there would be all these gay jokes. And nowadays, that wouldn't fly. But back then, they were letting them rip.
Right. And then later, Bosom Buddies. The two guys pretended to be... They dressed as women.
Tom Hanks?
Yeah, exactly.
Tom
Similar,
Hanks,
you know.
They dressed like women to live in an all-women's building.
Right.
Tom Hanks, and then who was the other guy? Peter something.
Oh, yeah.
He was from... he was the guy on Newhart.
Oh, wow.
Newhart just died.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, I know.
Newhart died.
But he was 90 freaking whatever. And his buddy, his best friend, died not that much earlier, like a year or so earlier.
No, he looked terrible.
Well, he's 90-something.
I know, but he always looked good.
Yeah, up to his 80s or something, I'm sure, you know? That's a freaking good life, I guess, you know?
Great life.
Yeah, I mean...
Okay, this is the cast. This is John Ritter, Suzanne Summers, Joanne DeWitt, and then what was Mr. Roper's name? Norman something.
Oh,
I don't
wow.
remember Mrs. Roper's name.
And then they got replaced by that funny guy from Don Knotts.
Played same Mr. time. Furley. So what happened was the Ropers, this show was doing so well, they wanted to do a spinoff. And they were like, oh, let the Ropers do a spinoff. But the Ropers didn't want, the main guy, he didn't want to leave because he was like, oh, I'm on a hit show.
Right.
I don't want to go to another show. They said, look, do the spinoff.
We'll give it back to you.
We'll give it back to you if your show doesn't work. Then they got Mr. Furley. Mr. Furley was a hit.
Yep.
So when their show failed, they were like, sorry, guys, you can't come back.
Yeah. We're taking that back. They screwed them.
They fucked
them. We promise you with broken promise.
Look, dear, Jack can read without moving his lips. That was Mrs. Roper talking shit about Mr. Roper. Great show, man. I was just watching it. I was on tour with Bert Kreischer. I'm a big name dropper.
On the buses and stuff.
I be name dropping.
That's fine.
I be name dropping.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So I was on a bus with Bobby Lee.
Oh, damn. I've not met either of those two gentlemen.
What about Chad Daniels? incredible comedian.
Yeah. Oh, I don't know Chad Daniels.
Kelsey Cook, maybe?
There is a Kelsey Cook. Kelsey Cook. I think so.
Who else was
not Kelsey Grammer.
Kelsey Grammer was not on the tour. Kelsey Cook.
Hope it's Kanks.
And then somebody else. But we were watching Three's Company every night on Pluto TV.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, what's this now?
Oh, that's like a part of a puzzle? Double puzzle piece. So there's two different puzzles that you do, I think. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's amazing.
To try to entice you to buy more, you know, whatever.
So here's the blonde. That's definitely Suzanne Summers.
Yep.
Suzanne,
yep.
My friend worked for Suzanne.
Hey, Aaron Burke.
Aaron Burke.
How was your freaking set, man? Are you going now?
I'm going now.
You kick gum? What, you got the whole script?
You want gum from 1980?
So many people have eaten it.
I'm ready for you.
You want gum from
1980? Oh, there's Joe. He runs this freaking place. He's going to do a pack later, hopefully.
Yes.
Man, this is awesome.
Fudge pack.
So all you gotta do is great sign show. One for me, Cipha.
Okay,
and
which one should I sign?
That's your choice.
Do I sign the front, the back?
There's no rules. You do whatever you want.
Rules. I mean, you gotta sign the front, right?
People have done both.
Okay, I'll sign. That'd be super gay if I signed a puzzle piece, right?
You can do anything. It doesn't matter. I don't think there's anything gay about signing any of the cards.
Signing is gay. Everybody knows that.
You didn't like John Hancock?
John Hancock?
Well, he signed the big thing on the Declaration of Independence. I know Hancock, yeah.
But Cock, you know why he signed the biggest? Because he had the biggest.
Because he had the biggest cock, yeah. He was out there fraternizing instead of doing whatever he was supposed to be doing.
Hey, what's your name?
David Bacon.
Oh, I knew that. David Bacon?
Mm-hmm. B-A-C-O-N.
Like the pork?
Yeah.
I don't eat pork, though.
Yeah, and I kind of look Jewish, and I got, you know.
Are you Jewish?
My dad, well, I'm adopted, so the Bacon name isn't even my real, like that, you know, like that's a name.
Being related to Kevin?
Well, I'm not, because that's not my birth family's name.
You think your birth family's related to Kevin Bacon?
I don't think so.
But you've never looked into it?
Well.
Hold on, put the camera up. You sit around here and collect all these cards from different eras,
yeah.
And different genres, and different categories. And you haven't done the research.
No, I've met him.
Oh, you met him?
Yeah, yeah. But my dad was also adopted, so I couldn't go any further, which was whack.
Is that a thing where adopted people adopt people?
Well, it might be troubled stuff. Like, you know,
yeah.
His family was like broken up, I think my birth mom was 15 or something, you know?
Yeah.
15, 16, 15, 17, the couple, you know, so they...
My mom was 16 when she had me. She kept me.
Yeah.
Make you feel bad?
No, I mean...
My mom's name is...
I think
Jenny.
White people adopted...
Yeah.
Put kids up for adoption. There were homes at the time.
Yeah.
And so...
Yeah, I've seen Oliver Twist.
Well, they would, you know, they'd take the women away. They would make up a story that they were whatever.
Right.
And then when the lady would be separated from the family and stuff, and then the place would be like, hey, you should really give up your baby.
Right.
Like,
right.
You know, she was like, I mean, she could, who knows what's true, but she's like, you know, hey, like, I kind of felt coerced in a way of how the whole thing, you know? And I've read a book about the thing, and it's like, oh, yeah, that seems like that was the thing, because there was a demand for white babies at the time. Abortion, although there was no abortion in 69. Well,
we need more white babies.
I don't think that's
true. Let me tell you something.
We don't need more white babies.
My mom's name, your name is David Bacon.
Yeah.
My mom's name is Jenny Porkshoulder.
Yeah. This fucking guy. And that's the kind of comedy you can expect. Maybe we should listen to his beats. That was hilarious. Oh, Cipha, it's so cool because, you know, I've seen you multiple times and, you know, you're always running from gig to gig, so it's nice. I think you're doing another set here, then you're going somewhere else. So.
Man, that's so dope. Thank you. No, thanks
awesome,
for having
man.
Me on the show.
Thanks
this
so
is
much.
A dope show.
And hey, go see live comedy because that's what's happening. Comedians open cards! Oh, that was so awesome.
Good.
Thank
Thanks,
you so
Dave.
Much.